If really watching the rushes is the first trait shared by those who write well for pictures, then the second is listening to the rushes and understanding the importance of sound. Now, if you've got a good picture story on your hands, somebody is bound to say to you, let the pictures breathe. This isn't just about letting the shots run long. It's as much about the sound as the vision. The best picture editors will usually want a minimum of 10% of the allotted duration to break up the track with natural sound. A good script is written with that up sound in mind. Avoid editing in the pauses in the track. Build them into the structure of your script. One of the secrets of great writing to pictures is not writing at all.
For a moment, the sleepy calm of Port Stanley is shattered. The noise bothers no one. It reassures. The islanders believe themselves well defended, secure in their windswept Britishness. Britain says the islands are prepared for any future Argentine threat.
It's impossible to know what's going on behind the eyes of Anders Breivik. Hard to see if the evil he carried out haunts him, whether he hears the screams of those he killed. Breivik maintains that his horrific attacks came after he joined a network of like-minded nationalists. The police here doubt such a network exists.
How suddenly it strikes. Mortal danger descends almost in the blink of an eye, and without warning. It is terrifying. In an instant, there is chaos. Then, from the vastness of the sea, there is a threat more menacing still. A wall of water more than 20 feet high advances across the ocean at speeds of up to 500 miles an hour, the speed of a jet aircraft. Imagine being in this office, in Sendai, when this happens. For a moment, they freeze, immobilized by panic. Then, a frantic scramble for shelter. And the quake goes on and on and on.